I'm going to explain you how to use a dragger pump and how to check the gases by using the dragger pump. Dragger pump is basically based on the principle that there's in the tube, there's a chemical reaction inside it and it will change the color and you can read the ppm from here. But the tubes are required only as per the IVC code where the toxic detection is required. Some ships you don't find a dragger pump or a gas tank pump because you have a toxic gas meter. From that you can check. But as on this vessel, we are going to explain you how to check with a dragger. So for dragger, according to the cargo, you have the tubes available. For me, for example, I have a cargo sample of ethylene dichloride. Now ethylene dichloride, as per IVC chapter 17, is a toxic cargo. So we have to use the dragger tubes to check the gases whenever we're doing the main entry to confirm whether the EDC vapors are there or not, or is it harmful to the my people who are entering for them. For EDC, there's not a specific tube available in the dragger or the gas tank. The tube available for the EDC is methyl bromide. So first of all, you have to see whether you have the tubes or not available for the cargo you are carrying. After it is confirmed and when you do the tank cleaning, before entering into the tank, you have to check the gases. For gas tank, as I said, methyl bromide is the tube, R tube. First, when you open the methyl bromide tube, it will open like this. It's a two-tube combination. Methyl bromide is a two-tube combination. As you can see, it's a two tubes. One tube is here, one tube is here. So it's a two-tube combination. And whenever you open a dragger tubes, whenever you open the packet, you will find an instruction manual. This instruction manual is very important. It has to be kept with the tubes all the time. In this, you will find in various languages. Let's see what does it say in English. So it will tell you about the application range and the ambient condition in which the tube has to be used. For example, for this tube, basically, this can read up from 5 ppm to 50 ppm. So whenever you have a EDC vapors less than 5 ppm, it will not able to tell you. So as the TLV, threshold limit value of the EDC is 10 ppm. So generally we take 50% of that. So 5 ppm, less than 5 ppm is good enough to work in that environment. So this is the tube. I'll give you a closer for that. So after reading this, this is the brochure. This is what you get. So in this, the major range is 5 to 50 ppm. The number of stroke is 5. Some people call it N is equal to 5 because it is given on the tube, N is equal to 5. It means how many strokes you have to give from this dragger pump to use the tube. If you see the countdown, the dragger tubes have the countdown here. You can keep it zero by pressing this button and it will become zero. From zero, you can start counting the strokes. The most important is the stroke should not be like this. Whatever the measuring time is given, here the measuring time is approximate 1 minute. So for 1 minute, in 1 minute you have to press 5 times. So that is in 12 seconds you have to press twice. It automatically, whenever the tube is here, you will see automatically is taking a longer time comparison what is given in the chart. Then you have an accuracy range of plus minus 20 to 30%. The color change. As it is a green color tube, it will change the color to brown about around the ppm when it is getting. Then you have the temperature range. It can work in 0 to 40 degree. In 0 to 40, you have to see the corrections applied for the pressure, for the temperature. For 5 to 9 ppm, if you are using this tube in a temperature of 0 to 7 degrees Celsius, there is a correction of 1.3. So if you are getting a 5 ppm, so you multiply it 1.3. So exact ppm, what you get, you will get in the tube. You have to write down that reading, not the what you have shown in the tube. Same for 8 to 15. It's different for every different temperature and how much you are measuring. But as we are at ambient temperature, and for ambient temperature up to 40 degrees Celsius, you don't have to apply any corrections. The principle of the reaction is given, that how it works. It's a methyl bromide is present in the tank. It will react with the silver dioxide and give you whatever the reaction, and the bromide gives you the brown color. Now let's see how to use this tube. So first, I'm going to, as you can see, it's a two tube version. You have a vinyl coating over here. First you have to break this coating, then one tube is broken, then you have to go to other side and break the other end. So both the end of the tube should be broken. It should bend like this, but it should not cut the this part. Now, first of all, whenever using the dragger pumps, first check the integrity test of itself of the pump. What you will do is, you press the pump, you put the tube inside and you leave it. If it is coming back to the normal original position, means there is a leak in the tube, in the pump, there is a leak in the pump. So you see there is no upcoming it, so you remove the tube and it releases. Again, put the countdown to zero. Now let's start checking.